Assalamualaikum and hello everyone. I am Nusyafika binti Mat Suhari and I'll be presenting my student research day presentation entitled Production of Microbial Bioplastics PHA using Palm Oil Mill Effluent POM. This is the scope of my project. And the objective is to investigate the effectiveness of palm oil mill effluent POM in the PHA producing bacterial growth. My hypothesis is the most optimum concentration of POM fed to the bacteria cuprovidus species will produce the highest bacterial growth. The problem statement is, first, there are still many undiscovered waste and materials that can effectively produce bioplastic, abundance of waste produced by palm oil industry in Malaysia annually, and the waste is either just burned in the open air or left to settle in waste ponds. And the third one is the use of POM for production of bioplastics can reduce the amount of POM that needed for the treatment. My experimental design started with the bacterial screen maintenance and culture conditions, followed by carbon source POM and media preparations, and then biosynthesis of P3HB using various concentration of POM, and the total cell dry weight determination, and lastly, the result of observation and interpretation. This is my result. This is the growth of the bacteria in 15 miniature broth. The bacteria strain, which is cuprovidus species, TMT11, that was isolated from Teguh Megah Timur pond, stored in 20% glycerol stock. And then the bacteria were grown in 15 miniature broth and the absorbance reading were taken to determine the optimum time needed for the bacteria to grow. And this is the growth curve that was obtained. And the curve showed that the optimum growth for cuprovidus species was around 8 to 12 hours. This is the graph of absorbance reading for 5, 10, 15, and 20 gram per liter POM after 24, 40, and 72 hours. The activated bacteria were transferred into 4 conical flasks containing 50 ml of mixture of POM, mineral media, trace element, and distilled water. And then each flask contained 5, 10, 15, and 20 gram per liter POM extract respectively. The experiment was done in triplicate for 24, 40, and 72 hours, and the absorbance reading were taken. The absorbance data later was inserted into the equation that was obtained from the graph of biomass against absorbance. And this is the graph that was obtained. The graph of biomass of bacteria growth for 5, 10, 15 and 20 gram per liter POM after 24, 40 and 72 hours. Based on the results in figure 2 and 3, there was no significant difference for absorbance reading of 5 gram per liter POM from 24 to 72 hours. The highest absorbance reading was after 72 hours with 20 gram per liter POM extract. There was significant difference for 10 gram per liter POM from 24 to 40 hours, but there was no significant difference after 72 hours. The highest absorbance reading for all 24, 40 and 72 hours was with 20 gram per liter POM extract. The discussion, Cuprovidus species is one of the most common used bacteria in producing PHA. So in this study, locally isolated Cuprovidus species TMT11 were used. Persona et al. 2013 stated that Cuprovidus negata could produce up to 12.29 gram per liter PHA when cultured in a media made from digested liquor. Another study by Barazina and 2013 also reported that Cuprovidus negata could enhance its productivity by 33 times when cultivated on enriched media without any limiting factors. Based on figure 1, the optimum growth time for Cuprovidus species was around 8 to 12 hours. This amount of time would produce the optimum amount of bacteria to be used in biosynthesis process. The biosynthesis process involved the feeding of bacteria using various concentrations of POM, which were 5, 10, 50 and 20 gram per liter. POM was considered as a suitable substance to be as carbon source. Alias and Tan, 2005, also reported that 2 out of 7 bacteria that were isolated and fed with POM as carbon source could produce polytrihydroxybutyrate. Figure 3 showed that the reading was highest after 72 hours in 20 gram per liter POM extract. Previous study by Samiati et al. 2007 stated that high concentration of volatile fatty acid VFAs excess from POM contributed to higher production of PHAs. The absorbance reading indicated the growth of the bacteria, and it was assumed that higher growth rate of the bacteria will be contributed to higher production of P3HP. In conclusion, this study has provided a preliminary knowledge in the effectiveness of POM to be used as carbon source and help in the growth of Cuprovidus species. POM contains high amount of fatty acids that can be utilized by the bacteria in PHA productions. Therefore, POM extract is one of the most highly recommended substances that can be used as carbon source. It is also recommended that more research on other highly potential substances should be carried out in the future. This is my reference and that's all. Thank you.